So I'm joined now by One Republic's frontman, Ryan Tedder. Hello, Ryan. Welcome to the official chart. How are you?
Good. Great.
Good. How are you? Lovely to have you. I'm good. It's exciting to meet you. It's been an amazing time. I've just been watching your song to go through the chart, just kind of inching and inching and inching, and then it kind of stayed near number three. We didn't know where it was going to go. And then suddenly, out of nowhere, number one.
We cut a gap in the clouds.
What happened? But it's not even a gap in the clouds. I mean, there was no room. You've just got hit upon hit coming out at the moment. And yet your song just powered through. Yeah. So congratulations, though. How does it feel now that you are officially number one?
Well, I feel definitely less illegitimate.
And, okay, good.
It feels great, to be honest. I mean, it was. I'm not joking. So we get into London last night.
Sure.
Walk around the corner to the Clarence pub, sit down, had not been sitting down 30 seconds. We'd been in London all of an hour and a half, and a group of like four or five guys walked by, a couple guys from Manchester and a couple from London, and they're like, I'm not gonna attempt the accent, but they were like,
please do.
I know, you always try to get Americans to do that.
I'll do the rest of the interview in an American accent if you're willing to try the Mancunian accent.
Oh, congrats to number one, mate.
That's really good.
Yeah, there you go.
I'm going to have to do the rest of the interview.
No, literally, the guy reaches over and goes, and the whole band was there. He's like, in One Republic, he's like, hey, congrats on number one. And they were all like, yeah, congrats. We'd been sitting for 30 seconds and it was a bunch of random dudes. And
that's how you found out you're number one.
No, that was the first people we saw in London. So it was the most bizarre situation.
Well, you know what? We haven't had a chance to make it official because it was last Sunday that you got your number one. I've got this big, shiny, very heavy award. I'm not going to throw it at you because you're quite far away. It would kill you. Yeah. So I'm just going to keep it here. And if you're very well behaved during the interview, you get it at the end.
I appreciate it. I'll do my best.
Some of the people that you've written for, I mean, the likes of Beyonce, Leona Lewis, Adele, and of course now Ellie Goulding.
Yeah.
Have you ever written a song for someone and then just kept it for yourself?
Yes. There's a song. Only one ever. And it's because of Brent, the guy I did Burn with, actually.
Blame it on Brent.
Blame it on Brent.
Brent's not here, can't defend himself.
This album we did, I spent about a year making Native and recorded. Actually, funny enough, we finished Counting Stars in London at Rack, Rack Studios. There's a song on the record called Can't Stop that I didn't do for One Republic. And there was one artist who I absolutely cannot name who almost cut it and then passed on it. Because the lyrics, they couldn't connect with, the lyrics weren't personal for them.
Okay.
As much as they were for me. And so, and then I ended up playing them the final version of the song after it was done, and they were like, oh, we should have kept it.
Oh, please tell me who
I literally cannot. I'm sorry, I can't.
Are there any young women in the UK that you have your eye on for writing with, perhaps? I mean, I know that you've cited that you're a fan of the likes of London Grammar.
Yeah, I'm a fan of London Grammar. I'm just now watching them. I think Churches is pretty cool. I think that's their stuff's really interesting. I'm curious to see where they go. You know, I'm a fan of obviously Ellie. I'd love to do more stuff with Ellie. Mm-hmm. She just has such a unique voice.
I think she'd be okay with that. Seeing as this was her first ever UK number one.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
I didn't even know that. Okay, that's awesome.
Oh yeah, you're knocking out first all over the shop. Congratulations.
I had no idea. Florence, I would absolutely.
That'd be amazing.
Love to do something with Florence.
All right, Ryan Tedder, I'm holding your number one. Before I give it to you to say congratulations for last Sunday, would you be so kind as to introduce your record, which was our number one last week, to the nation?
Absolutely. Hey, everybody, this is Ryan from One Republic, and this is our song, Counting Stars.
Here's your thing.
Oh, it's heavy.
It is heavy, isn't it? Thank you, Ryan Tedder.
Love it.
Like a swinging vine, swing my heart across the line. In my face is flashing sun.